In this video, we will show you how to assemble and set up the RXD250 racing quad. When you open the box, you will see the quadcopter and a bag with the props, receiver cable, tubes for the antenna mounts, screws for the FPV camera plate, and Velcro for the battery. You will need a transmitter and receiver with at least 6 channels and a 3-cell LiPo with a 1300 to 2200 milliamp hour capacity. Serial receivers like the Futaba S-Bus and satellite receivers cannot be used with the receiver cable that is included with the RXD250. The 8-pin receiver port will be found on the front of the flight controller. Please follow the chart on page 6 of the manual when plugging the wires into the receiver. Mount the receiver in front of the flight controller and route the antennas through the antenna mounts. Install the tubes to protect the antennas. There are 2 clockwise props and 2 counterclockwise props for this quadcopter. The clockwise props have just the size 60-30 molded on one blade. They should be installed on the front left and rear right motors. The counterclockwise props have 60-30R molded on one blade. They should be installed on the front right and the rear left motors. The transmitter model type should be normal airplane with a switch that can be used to change flight modes. None of the channels need to be reversed. The receiver should be linked in the failsafe set before it is installed in the RXD250. The flight controller uses Libre Pilot for its control software. You can download the Ground Control Station or GCS app from this website. Select the appropriate version for your computer. The USB drivers will be loaded when the app is installed. To prevent injury in case the motors are armed, always remove the props before connecting the RXD250 to the GCS app. Have a battery ready, but not yet connected to the quadcopter. When the installation is complete, open Libre Pilot. Connect your mini USB cable to the computer and to the USB port on the left side of the controller. The connection status window will show a green dot for the transmitter status and several dots for the data received from the controller. The LED on the controller will be flashing slowly. Click Next. An upgrade for the firmware is not necessary unless there was a compatibility message displayed when the controller was connected to the GCS app. Click Next. This screen shows which controller is connected to the GCS. It should always be the CC3D. Click Next. This page is used to select the appropriate receiver type. It should be PWM. Click Next. This page is used to select the type of vehicle that is using the controller. It should always be multirotor. Click Next. This page is used to select the type of multirotor that is using the controller. It should always be Quadcopter X. Click Next. This page is used to select the type of ESC that is on the quad. The Rapid ESC should be selected. Click Next. This page reviews the settings selected so far. If the settings are correct, click Next. This page is used to reset the sensors on the flight controller. Place the RXD250 on a level surface and click the Calculate button. When the calculations are done, click Next. Click on the boxes next to the safety warnings, and then click the Start button. Connect the battery to the underside of the quad. As soon as you hear the ESC chime, click on the Stop button. Leave the battery connected to the RXD250. Click Next. Note the correct direction of rotation of the motors. If the propellers have been removed, click Next. Click on the Start button. Slowly move the slider to the right. The motor should start spinning when the output value is above 1100 microseconds. Stop moving the slider when the motor is running smoothly and click on the Stop button. Watch the motor as it stops spinning and verify that it is spinning in the proper direction. Note that the motor number 3 is spinning. This will be corrected later in the Vehicle and Attitude sections. When the motor has stopped spinning, click Next. The same calibration procedure is used for the other motors. Note that motor number 2 is spinning. When the motor has stopped spinning, click Next. Note that motor number 1 is spinning. This will be corrected later. When the motor has stopped spinning, click Next. Note that motor number 4 is spinning. When the motor has stopped spinning, click Next. The recommended tuning settings are already loaded on the controller. Verify that the current tuning option is selected and click Next. Click on the Save button. the controller will reboot and the GCS app will start the transmitter setup wizard. The RXD250 should be powered and linked to the transmitter. Click Next. Click OK in the warning box and then click Next. The Acro option should be selected. Click Next. The Mode 2 option should be selected. Click Next. This screen tells the GCS app which channels are used for the controls. Move the appropriate stick or switch when prompted. Click Next for the accessory switches. Center both sticks and the flight mode switch. Click Next. Move both sticks to all four corners and then center them when completed. Move the flight mode switch in both directions, then center it. Click Next. Verify that both sticks and the flight mode switch have the correct response and click Next. Select the Yaw Right option for the arming setting and click on the Save button to save the changes. Click on Vehicle. The setting for motor output channel 1 equals channel 3, and the motor output channel 3 equals channel 1. Save the setting change by clicking on the Save button. Click on Attitude. Verify that the roll pitch settings are 0 and the yaw setting is negative 90. Click the Save button if changes have been made. The RXD250 is now set up. Check out the Hobbies How-To channel for our next video,